She has just welcomed His Excellency the President, made accountability of who she's in command of, and invited him to inspect the parade.
Initiating at the 61st National Independence Day celebrations held in Kitugumo District, President Museveni said the main theme of his speech was derived from the Book of Common Prayer of 1662 of the Church of Uganda, which says, "They left undone what they ought to have done, and they did that they ought not to have done, and there is no truth in them." He said the scripture describes well the many situations in the world, and especially in Africa. The ceremony ran under the theme, "Sustaining a united and progressive nation, taking charge of our future as a free nation."
I congratulate you on the 61 years of Uganda's independence. In last night's speech, I therefore tried to point out what we ought not to concentrate our minds on and those factors that we ought to emphasize.
The president said the first crucial ingredient is rejecting the pseudo-ideology of emphasizing the politics of identity and instead emphasizing the politics of interests.
Rejecting the pseudo-ideology of identity politics, meaning religion, tribes, gender chauvinism, and promoting the ideology of interests, which where you deal with the needs, markets of people's products, jobs, wealth creation, that we have demonstrated that it promotes prosperity of society.
The president explained that the four principles of NRM include patriotism, Pan-Africanism, socio-economic transformation, and democracy. He noted that the ideology of patriotism and Pan-Africanism also promotes harmony among the people.
And the leaders, especially the political leaders, the administrative leaders, you need to understand the importance of the private sector, because it helps us to develop our country with little, without too much supervision, because these people work for themselves, but in the process they build our country.
President Museveni listed the third ingredient as economic infrastructure, especially electricity, railway, roads, ICT backbone, airports, piped water, irrigation canals, among others. He noted that these are crucial so as to create connectivity by linking the producers with the consumers in a bid to lower cost of doing business and stabilizing agriculture, thus making Uganda's products plentiful and competitive. The fourth ingredient, according to President Museveni, is social infrastructure in form of schools, health centers, and research institutions that will help Uganda or are helping the country to deal with the health, knowledge and skills of the human resource. The president outlined a number of other ingredients that can steer development, and these included fighting corruption and protecting Uganda's environment, which means the wetlands, forests and other resources.
Now, you remember some years ago we guided you to emphasize the teaching of science in schools and in universities. These centers have created world-class scientists, some of whom are these ones who are here. Number five is regional economic and political integration. The good thing in Africa is that people are still asleep. And when you are asleep, you don't know what will kill you.
On the issue of cattle rustling, President Museveni assured the people in Acholi sub-region that the government has managed to curb down the criminal activity and they're now planning to intensify their operations so as they put an end to the vice.
The insecurity caused by the cattle rustlers, when we met in Balegi, we agreed on what to do. And I'm sure things have changed and we are going to put more capacity. But what I found out is that some of your leaders were also involved in the stealing of cows.
The president also launched Bingwa, a locally made three-wheel multipurpose vehicle manufactured by Keverton Motions Engineering Limited with the assistance of Kiram Motors Corporation.
Your Excellency, that vehicle is unique. It can carry one ton. It can generate power, 6 kilowatts. And it can also pump up to 6,000 liters per hour of water for irrigation. Your Excellency, the vehicle is fully built in Uganda by our engineers, and all the parts and materials are locally sourced up to 55%.
The Vice President of Burundi extended warm greetings from the President of Burundi to the people of Uganda and congratulated them upon reaching the 61st independence anniversary.
His Excellency, General Major Evariste Ndayishimiye, and now Chairperson of East African Community, tries to manage in order to see EAC become a large economic community with one people and one destiny. Long live to His Excellency Yoweri Kaguta Museveni. Long live to Ugandan's people. Long live to EAC and to the whole Africa. God bless you, all of you. Thank you very much.
The United Arab Emirates Minister of State for Foreign Affairs also congratulated President Museveni and the people of Uganda on reaching the milestone.
President of the United Arab Emirates would like to congratulate Your Excellency and the people of Uganda on the 61st Independence Day. Our two countries enjoy a cordial and a respective relationship, and we look forward for a strong relationship between our two countries. Thank you, Your Excellency, and God bless you all.
The Minister for Presidency, Mili Babalanda, congratulated Ugandans upon reaching the 61st Independence Day celebrations and commended President Museveni for touching the many lives of Ugandans, changing and improving the fortune of an entire nation.
Your Excellency, on behalf of Ugandans, I congratulate you upon reaching this important day when you are in good health and with good energy to continue guiding this country. Your Excellency, sir, your life deserves to be celebrated by all. You have touched many lives, changed and improved the fortunes of an entire nation, and sacrificed all for the good of Uganda and the world at large.
The event was also attended by the Vice President of Uganda, Her Excellence Jessica Alupo, the Deputy Prime Minister of Tanzania, His Lordship Alphonse Owinyidolo, Deputy Speaker of Parliament Thomas Tayebwa, Third Deputy Prime Minister Right Honorable Kia Isanga Nakadama, ministers, members of parliaments, security forces, members of the diplomatic corps, religious and cultural leaders, among others.